You know, this channel, with regards to the DMCA, it's really been kind of a mixed bag. On the one hand, from the very beginning, I've had to deal with problems with bogus DMCA takedowns, videos being taken down because, you know, the person didn't like the way I took down their bogosity, and so they were using it as a way to try and silence me. So yeah, I have experienced filing counter notices and all the usual stuff that a lot of channels have to deal with. On the other hand, it's given me a lot of material. So here we are. This is about, and a lot of you may be aware that they just got GitHub to take down the YouTube DL software to actually download the YouTube videos, and they're going after a bunch of others now. And this is totally a DMCA thing, so what they're talking about is stream ripping. This is where you actually can take the video pretty much bit for bit, what YouTube sends, and saves it down to your hard drive. Now, there are perfectly legitimate reasons to do this. You know, I do a lot of reaction videos. To do the reaction video, I want to play a clip of the video I'm talking about and then give my reaction to it. A lot of YouTubers do that. How do we do it? Well, we got to get that video down to our hard drive so we can edit it in with the video that we're making. You know, another good reason is if you have permission from the people that do it. You know, I pretty much give everyone permission to do whatever they want to with my stuff, because I don't really believe in copyright or IP. I'll usually make my videos like this one, at least under Creative Commons, and that's because I don't really own all of the stuff I do. Like in this case, I don't own this Torrent Freak article that I'm going into. And so, you know, if I say, hey, all this is public domain, then they go, oh, okay, well, I can post the Torrent Freak article. Well, that's not up to me. That's up to Torrent Freak as to whether you can repost the article. But you can do whatever you can with my portion of it. But again, in order to do that, you need to get it down on your hard drive. Now, by copyright, by all the copyright laws that exist pretty much everywhere, that's perfectly fine. Now, standard disclaimer, I'm not a lawyer. This is not legal advice. But yeah, that's perfectly fine. You can do that. However, the DMCA makes it illegal, actually, to bypass any kind of DRM or any kind of anti-circumvention measure, no matter how weak or stupid it is. And so that's what we have here. They're talking about this rolling cipher protection. And Torrent Freak says, while it may sound complex, anyone can download full audio and video files from YouTube using nothing more than a web browser. You don't need all this specialized software to do it. It's surprisingly easy, and we fail to spot any ciphers. Now, there is an issue of terminology here. A rolling cipher is a really, really weak form of kid-sister cipher, like those decoder rings you used to get in cereal boxes. You know, that's really, it's like one step up from a Caesar cipher. I don't think that's what they're talking about. I think what they're talking about is a rolling code. And so a rolling code is where you have your secret encryption key, and then you combine it with something like a counter. So you have your key, you have your counter, and you run it through HMAC SHA-256 or something like that, and you get this whole big messed up thing that doesn't resemble your inputs at all. And that's what you do. You just keep incrementing that counter and making new encryption keys to encrypt things with. Well, that's not actually making a new encryption key, because fundamentally you're using that same master secret to do all of that. Now, there are perfectly valid times where you'd want to do that. Squirrel uses that, actually, because Squirrel works by giving you a unique challenge cipher, a little piece of random stuff in the URL, so that every signature that you sign to prove that you are who you say you are ends up being unique and it can't be replayed. So it protects against replay attacks. And one of the recommended methods for generating that is just to have a counter, mix the counter with your server's private key, and then just have the result of that, you know, just incrementing it, you know, run that through a bcrypt or something like that. Because you just need 64 bits. You don't need that much for this particular purpose. Because you're not actually encrypting anything with it. It's just a unique challenge. So apparently what they're talking about, and I'm not really sure because they don't actually do this. They don't do anything resembling this. But it's a rolling code where they just keep incrementing. And then with each increment, they use that as the encryption key, which is not a very secure way of doing things, but... According to the DMCA, it doesn't have to be good. It just has to be there. And if you circumvent it, then you're in violation. And so the Torn Freak, this is Ernesto Vandersar, says, despite this restriction, there are numerous dream-ripping tools available on the web that do just that. These tools have legal uses, as I just pointed out, but they're a thorn in the side of the music industry who see them as a major piracy threat. So they talk about the Rolling Cipher protection measure. It sounds rather complicated, but publicly, little is known about how it works. To find out more, we reached out to YouTube, which didn't respond to our inquiry. Is this starting to sound a little similar to something that I've covered recently? Maybe we'll get to that in a minute. However, we did find out more about the Rolling Cipher in a judgment from a German court in Hamburg. This 2017 verdict was explicitly mentioned in the RIAA's takedown request to GitHub. At the Hamburg court, copyright holders argued that YouTube's Rolling Cipher is an effective technological protection measure under EU law. Rolling ciphers are not effective. They are not. It is so complex that average users can't decipher it. In the case of the video at issue, the user would have to filter out 22 encoded URLs from a total of 72,338 characters, then find the S variable of each URL, decipher it using the respectively valid because changing key, and the newly generated URL used to get the video, the argument was. And so this is a technical measure within the meaning of Copyright Act. So, did you catch the relevant point? This is so complex that average users can't decipher it. What did I just make a video on, people? Security through obscurity. That's what this is. And that's why YouTube wouldn't respond to them about this. They don't want you knowing anything about this because they're trying to keep the algorithm itself secret. And that never works. They should be able to say, yes, here is our algorithm. Here is everything you need to know about this, except our secret private keys on the server. But we all know DRM doesn't work like that, right? Because in order for your browser to play the video, it needs to be able to decrypt it. So whatever encryption key it's using, it needs to give that to your browser. So they're just giving you the key to do it. That's how all DRM works. And that's why it will never, ever, ever be secure. So, right. DIY downloading. At Torrent Freak, we have relatively little knowledge about encryption. So it should be impossible for us to bypass this Rolling Cipher, one would think. However, after a few Google searches, we learned that pretty much every browser can do this by default. Once you know the trick, it only takes 20 seconds or so. Our deciphering quest started in Chrome, but it works in Firefox and other browsers as well. Because we don't want any trouble, we used the Pirate Bay song as a test video, which is public domain. And the Open Chrome Dev Tools Inspector, which there's a certain thing in Firefox and pretty much every other browser. There's something where you can look at all of the elements that make up the web page, all of the code, all of the style sheets, everything else. And so they look over to the network inspector, which is all of the requests the web page makes over the network. So it says the DevTools inspector shows you what requests are made by a page. When we filter for the keyword audio, several URLs appeared, all pointing to chopped up audio streams from the YouTube video. Okay, and that supposedly makes this really complicated because you'd have to download all these pieces and then figure out how they go together. But, they say, without any encryption knowledge, we opened one of these streams in a separate browser tab. As expected, this didn't immediately bring up the full audio with the Pirate Bay song. That requires the extra step of removing the last part of the URL, which starts with range equals. So apparently what they're doing is they're linking you to the entire song, and then that range variable just gives you a bit of a song. But it still points to the entire thing. You just remove the range equals, And you've got it. As when that's done, the audio clip shows up in full and can be played just fine. In fact, Chrome even offers the option to download it. Yep, it's that easy. It's that crazy. And says, while we didn't dare go that far, we heard that it indeed saves just fine. Well, the thing is, at that point, it's already saved to the browser. Once you get that little, you know, browser-specific MP3 player, audio player thing, yep, it's already on your computer. Even without the download thing, all you'd have to do is just go to the temporary files folder where your browser cache is, grab it from there. So there we have it. In just a few clicks and keystrokes, we managed to bypass YouTube's copyright protection using a browser. We didn't see any rolling Cipher in the process, and anyone can do it. This brings us back to the RIAA's takedown request and the cited court verdict, which said that an average user is not able to access the video info file, let alone decipher it. Either we are geniuses, or the court statement is wrong, at least for the present situation. The above is the simple conclusion, but there's more to it, which gets a bit technical, which is, where's the encryption? This is like saying, where's the beef? Where's the encryption? You said you encrypted it. And so you said that bypassing that encryption makes it a DMCA violation. So, well, after talking to several experts, we learned that YouTube uses different signatures for video URLs. A signature is not encryption. It does not scramble it in any way. It just signs it to let you know that it hasn't been tampered with. That's all the signature does. So, most have a fixed SIG parameter, but there are others that use an S parameter. In the latter cases, the player's JavaScript is called with this S parameter, which varies or rolls. That parameter shuffling is likely what rights holders refer to with a rolling cipher. However, this doesn't involve any real encryption, and YouTube DL doesn't use it, as it simply executes the JavaScript code with a JavaScript interpreter, much like a browser does. Over the past weeks, dozens of experts have chimed in about the legality or illegality of tools such as YouTube DL. We're not going to add to this. These questions are ultimately up to a court to decide. But the fact is, you don't need the stream rippers. You don't need any of them. Just do it from the browser. There doesn't appear to be any encryption to stop average users from downloading files in a browser. Anyone can download audio and video from YouTube without a dedicated stream ripping tool. That leads us to the final question, which we will leave unanswered, or perhaps it answers itself. If YouTube DL is violating the DMCA because it allows people to download audio from YouTube, should browsers such as Chrome be outlawed as well? But even if there were encryption going on, again, you'd have to get the decryption key to the browser because the browser would need to be able to decrypt it to show it. So, how if that's illegal, then how can any form of DRM, any form of player or anything, be legal? Unless they're going to try to do what they tried to do initially with DVD players and say, hey, all DVD players must be manufactured by a member of the DVD consortium. Maybe that's what they're going to try to do. I don't know. But it's a legal measure. It's legal. It's not any way technical. Go ahead, change it. I just saw another headline. I didn't really look into the story, but the DRM keys and everything else that's being used to, you know, protect Disney and Hulu and things like that, they're changing those so that the rippers and the pirates can't do it. Well, yeah, that ought to slow them down for about an hour. Yeah. Doesn't take long, people. Doesn't take long. And they never learn. They never learn. We've been pointing this out for over 20 years. The DMCA was 1998. And we're still dealing with crap like this. I have no idea why. It's absolutely ridiculous, but thank you so much for watching. If you like it, then as usual, hit like and subscribe and share this everywhere. Please share it. You have my permission. Rip it, download it, you know, put it other places, do whatever you want to with it. But if you could really share this video and the link to it to get me a few more clicks and maybe some ad views, that would be good. Or if you want to support me directly, you can go to donate.bogosity.tv, even if it's just a few pennies in crypto, or you become a regular supporter at Patreon and Subscribestar, get all the videos early and ad-free. And thank you so much. Until next time, stay strong and be free.